Hello, my friend. In this video, I want to cover Spotify playlists and more specifically, how you can build your own Spotify playlist to increase your streams and your overall kind of career as an artist on Spotify. So in this video, we are going to be talking about the two reasons why it is so great to build Spotify playlists as an actual artist, and the three ways that you can actually grow these Spotify playlists. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I have a little freebie on how all this can be a lot easier for you when you're building your own Spotify playlists. So first things first, I want to show you exactly what I mean when I'm talking about building your own Spotify playlist. So this is an example of a playlist that I've built. It's the first one that I really tried building. It's called Lo-Fi Nights in the Sad House. You can see that it has 2,444 likes on it, or followers on the playlist. And one important thing, and this is kind of reason one of why this can be so useful for you as an artist, this is a playlist with 2,445 people on it, and the first song is my song, the second song is my song, the third song is my song, the fourth song is my song, the fifth song is my song. And throughout it, there's even more of my songs throughout it. But in addition to that, I'm also able to put two other kinds of artists. One is artists that sound kind of similar to me, or artists that I want the algorithm to make connections with me. So for example, an artist that I absolutely love is called Black Loops. Check him out if you're into kind of the same house music that I create. But the theory is that by placing your music beside an artist that you want to be related to, the Spotify algorithm, especially if it sees like, oh, this artist is on this playlist that's getting lots of streams and has a lot of active listeners on it, it can make a connection between those two artists. And then that way, on the other artist that you're trying to make a connection with, your music might get on like their radio playlists and get in the release radars of those particular listeners, because Spotify has created an association between you two. So those are kind of two of the really big reasons why this is important. One is that if you can build up the playlist to a decent amount, you get new streams on your music constantly, and it's pretty much for free if you're not paying for anything at this point in time. Especially if your music's at the top 5 position and all that, like all these songs are getting a decent amount of streams from this playlist, and whenever you release a new song, you can stick it up there and kind of boost that song in its first week or two or whatever you want to do. As long as it's up there, it'll get boosted streams, and you can make connections with other similar artists. And as another example, here is another one I'm just starting to build called Lo-Fi Running Beats to Run To. As you can see, again, top 3 songs in this instance are mine, and there's a group of artists that I'm trying to connect with here. Right now, this one's at 358 likes, and I've been working on it for about a month or two. I want to say 2 months I've been working on this. Now, I want to get into the second big reason. I guess it's maybe the third reason, but who cares? Who's keeping track? The third big reason is monetization. So once you can build a Spotify playlist to about 1,000 likes, you can apply to be on SubmitHub and Playlist Push. And if you're an artist, you may be familiar with these. These are when artists log into these and they'll pay a bunch of money to submit their music to different playlists to get on the playlist. You can actually be the playlist curator. So you can be on the other end of that. So once you have about 1,000, then you can actually be on those different sites and start making money from just listening to submissions and thinking about putting it on your playlist. You don't have to put it on your playlist, but you actually get paid to consider it, which is really cool. And in my experience so far, it's not a crazy amount of money, but I'm noticing about like between $50 and $150 US, depending on how active I am. Because you actually need to be on the site almost every day, making sure that you're listening to the new songs and approving or disapproving them and actually putting in some feedback. So it is a bit of work on your part for sure. But you can make somewhere around $100 US. And this can be super important, because particularly if you are struggling to find the money to run Facebook ads or anything like that for your own music, this little bit of income can be what you use to kind of finance that, I suppose. So say you're making $100 a month from the playlist, you can either use that to boost it into ads to build up that playlist even more, or if you're releasing music on a monthly basis, which is what I suggest you do, you now have a finance source in addition to your job and anything like that that you can use to directly kind of put that into Facebook ads for your own releases. So I think that's a really cool idea. particularly if you're a little bit financial conscious and you're having a hard time finding the money to put towards Facebook ads to grow your career. But you must be wondering, how can you actually grow one of these playlists? And I think there's about three different ways. And with anything, it's going to be either you're exchanging your time or you're exchanging your money. So first things first, exchanging your time. So the two ways that I could see you could do this is by hustling, of course. So you can create the playlist and you can kind of post it to different things. If you have a social media account, you can mention that you have a playlist there. Those kinds of things, I'm not really a big fan of those. I don't really like begging for attention in that way. But one thing that you can do is, I mentioned that you can put different artists on that playlist. So a really great idea would be to find smaller artists that are similar to you to put on your playlist, and that way whenever you put them on your playlist, you could actually reach out to them and let them know that they're on the playlist. And especially if you're starting to build up a decent amount of followers, they might be really happy about that, and then they may kind of share it with their own audience. And this happens to me a whole bunch with the playlist that I'm running. I'll add a artist, particularly sometimes with the Submit Hub and Playlist Push stuff, once I'll add one of those a bit smaller artists, they will post the like a story or something usually, and then that way I see that, I'm like, oh, that's cool, I'm getting a little bit of love for that, and then I'll do that reshare. So they're actually getting the benefit of being on the playlist, and then because I guess people are social animals, they see that, they want to share the fact that someone likes their playlist, they'll share it again. So I'll do that kind of reshare thing, and that's something that you could tap into yourself when you're building out your own Spotify playlist. You can actually be building connections with other artists, maybe getting them to share, but even the fact that you're building connections with other artists can be something really big and something really huge for your career. And lastly, obviously a big one, is running ads. So this is something that I've done to build these playlists a lot faster, is you can actually run Facebook and Instagram ads in a very similar way to that you would do it for Facebook and Instagram ads for growing like a new single that you're putting up on Spotify, but you just direct them over to a playlist. And this can be a fantastic way. It gets the results so much quicker, and you can find very targeted people to send over. Which I find is very useful, and it's just a lot faster. But of course, you're trading your money for this situation. Not everyone can do that, I understand that, but it's definitely a really good option. But with that said, those are kind of the overview of the idea. I'm really excited about the Spotify playlist thing. I think particularly because some conversations I've had with artists is that the Facebook, Instagram ad world seems like pretty much the best way to do it right now, but obviously not everyone has the financial means to do it. So I get kind of excited about this because it's a potentially cool way that you can make money directly from this playlist kind of strategy and then use it to fund your career, which I think could be fantastic. And then of course there's all the extra benefits of, you don't necessarily, if you build up a strong enough playlist, you wouldn't need to even run Facebook ads. Technically, you can just chalk your new song on that playlist and have that boosted up. As long as you have an active group of people on the playlist, like, it's such a powerful asset for you and for your music career in general. So with that said, I did mention that I had a little extra freebie that I could give away to you that will help you out and to kind of do this. And I've created a playlist checklist, a Spotify playlist checklist that you can check off. Gives you a whole bunch of ideas of how you can build up your own playlist and all the things that you need to do to get to that monetized state. It's completely free, and there will be a link to it in the description below. It gets into something that I forgot to mention actually in this video, but there's one extra tool that you can do to grow your playlist, and I'm going to show you that real quick. Didn't mean to jump around like this, but sometimes with these more vlog style videos, my brain jumps around. Unfortunately, I'm gonna get better at it, I swear. So I'm just gonna show you this in particular. Another technique that you can use to grow your playlist for free is, it's called SEO, search engine optimization. And if you're following this channel, you may notice that sometimes the titles that I'll structure are in particular ways. And that is because they're set up for what people are actually searching for, okay? So if you make content for how people are searching for things, then people will search for it and find you. That's basically the concept. It's called search engine optimization. So for this playlist in particular, you can see lo-fi running is something that I am trying to get people to search for and click, and beats to run to as well. And you can also do this in the description. So upbeat lo-fi would be a keyword, it's called. Lo-fi house music would be a keyword. So when people search for these things, the idea is that eventually this playlist will show up when you search for it. So we'll try right now just to see. So if you search for lo-fi running in the description box, I'm really hoping it works. B beautiful. So the top result, as you can see, if anyone's searching for lo-fi running right now, this is what comes up. So let's see also if you do beats to run to, I'm assuming. No, mine shows up too, which is really cool. But then I say if you do lo-fi house, which is another keyword, mine doesn't come up. So right now, my playlist is ranking for lo-fi running and it is ranking for beats to run to. So you can see if anybody types that in, my result shows up and then they're most likely to click, obviously, the top result. Right now, the main one's lo-fi house. So if you're doing this, you might want to have a look at see if Spotify has any playlists that are using that term that you want, because in most cases they'll probably show the Spotify one. But I think a main thing when you're doing this strategy is see if Spotify is doing it and then see what the top result is currently. So right now this one has 300,000 likes, for example. So in order for you or me to beat this, I think you would need to create a playlist with this title in it, this keyword, and you need to make more. You need to have more. So if I would need to have like maybe 400,000 likes in order to take over the top result. So that's something to keep in mind. So when you're building this out and you're creating your own titles, I would definitely consider putting that into action. It's a simple, small thing you can do. Just figure out what you want people to search for and what you want to rank for in that search result. Type it into the search bar there. See what shows up and see if you can beat them. So if it's if it only has like 50 likes or something like that, then you can probably get to 100 likes and start showing up in the search results. So that's a bonus little tip there. But anyways, sorry for the ramble. Hopefully that little bit of information was useful. Again, that playlist growth checklist is in the description below, so definitely check that out. Other than that, if you found this video useful, please make sure that you like and subscribe and all that good stuff so that you can see more of this juicy content. And other than that, good luck with your playlist if you decide to grow one, and good luck on your next release, and I will see you in the next video, my friend. Have a good one.